Hello student, welcome to your computer class. I am your computer teacher Archana. Today we will start our chapter 1. Chapter name is Computers, Storage and Memory Devices. I will complete this chapter in two part and this video contain first part. So let's start. In this video we will learn about the following topic. First is data and information, and second topic will be data storage unit. So what is data? Data is raw, unorganized fact that need to be processed. Data can be something simple and apparently random and useless until it is organized. There are multiple form of data as numbers, letters, set of character, images, graphic, etc. Now, what is information? When data is processed, organized, structured, or presented in a given context so as to make it useful, it is called information. That means when you organize your data and create in some way that you can use it, that is known as information. Information basically is the combination of data and whatever meaning you want to give to that data. So when you have any data and you can use it to create some meaning, that's become your information. Now let's take an example. When students get admission in a school, they fill an admission form with some detail, or your parents fill that admission form with some details. What these details can be? That can be student name, date of birth, father name, mother name, contact number, address, etc. School can use all these data to create student ID card or print their address label, or teacher can use such data to create attendance record or result. That is why school needs these data. Now, how data convert into information? For that, we have to collect all our raw data and process that data using our processing scheme. And after that, we get our result as information. Now let's talk about stages of the processing, like how we're going to process our data. First, we take all the data as our input. There are so many data which we can use to take as our input. Then we send all that input data for the processing. And how this processing will do? We can alter our data. So we can do some alteration, we can do any manipulation or arrangement. That arrangement can be, you can sort your data, ascending data, descending data, that all include your processing. Only after that, you are going to have your result, your output. So this is all the three stages of processing. First, you have to take your input, then all the processing will happen. After that, output is going to be generated. Now let's continue learning how computers store data. To store data, we need data storage unit. All the information stored in the computer is represented by 0 and 1 only. Computer can only understand 0 and 1. Computer do not understand any other character or any other number, only 0 and 1. These two digits, 0 and 1, are called binary digits. The measurement unit to describe these binary digit is bit, which is the short form for binary digit, and that bit, which is bit, is the smallest unit of the data. Now these bits is used to store all kind of information in our computer. It can be number, any text, video, audio, graphics, anything. To store information like this, we use bunch of bits together. The number of bits tell how much information we have. This is how we are going to measure our information. Let's take an example now. As you can see, for the decimal digit, binary digit is 000. For 1, binary digit is 001. So you can say 0 is 0 and 1 is 1 similarly. But for 2, the binary digit is 010. So whenever you write 2 or type 2 in computer, first computer is going to convert into binary digit, which is 010, and then computer only understand that you type 2. Similarly for 3 and 4 also, 3 we represent as 011 and 4 we represent as 100. This is how computer understand our decimal digit. Okay, so for our next term, if we store 4 bits together, that called one nibble, and if we are going to store 8 bits together, that is going to be one byte. For your information, I am going to tell you, if you type A in your computer, that A is going to store at least a bit, 8 bits space in your computer storage. That means that particular letter A is going to store at least one byte data, one byte storage unit in your computer. Similarly, if you increase your data, if you are going to increase the size of your data, if you are going to store image or any document, it will need more storage unit. So for that storage unit, we are going to show you so many storage unit types. After byte, you can store your data in kilobyte. 1 kilobyte is equals to 1024 bytes. Then after kilobyte, there is going to be megabyte, then gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, exabyte, zettabyte, and yottabyte. Each and every storage unit has its limit. Like 1 kilobyte can only store 1024 bytes. After that, if your data is greater than this, you can store your data into megabyte. And if your data is greater than 1024 kilobyte, you can store your data into gigabyte. That's how you can increase your data. But it is totally depend on your storage unit capacity. So this is all for the today's session. Thank you, student, and stay home, stay safe.